Wise Gemini here, aka Intellectual Gamer. I'm really, really frustrated and pissed off right now because I recorded 4 or 5 movies and I use Camstasia Studio. I use this Camstasia Studio and basically I didn't have it on window mode full screen and didn't get any of the recordings I did for 1.5 hours. And 2 days ago, I ended the intro because I wasn't ready to record it, and now I can't start the intro again in StarCraft 2. I missed the recording of me creating my username and password, the username, Wise Gemini. So basically, I missed a lot of stuff. And, I'm just trying to get stuff done right. So I have to put it in window mode, full screen, or window mode. And I added StarCraft 2. I didn't even pay for this. I didn't know whether or not it was gonna let me play for free on Wings of Liberty. I guess I don't have Wings of Liberty on this. As you know, I got annoying people outside in a business office. Okay, I'm gonna have to restart that to show you something that I just missed again. So I got annoying people in my playing blaring their bass, and I'm a musician. I play guitar, drums, and trumpet, and I'm telling you, don't use music to harm people. People are so freaking thoughtless. It's unempathetic. I pay to be here and I can't even get peace and quiet. I got thieves and ghetto hoodlums, gangbangers and tweakers. Gangbangers and tweakers messing with me out of here, stealing from me twice, looting my mail and one of my cars. 10,403 StarCraft games have been played, 23,053 players in chat rooms. Okay. Yada yada yada. I have to buy all this stuff. What is this? $60 for a trilogy. Yeah, 2016's been a real tough year. Getting banned from the gyms, real life problems. I'm gonna try to open up this tutorial and capture every piece of talking and footage. And I won't talk unless I have to, or unless I don't want to talk over the tutorial NPCs talking. And it gonna try to repeat everything I said in the first movie. Like your reactions to the game is that it's not natural, and you gotta think about, okay, what did I say before?
Welcome to the Dominion Future Commander Training Simulation Module. Here you will learn to use our interface and issue orders to your forces. Begin by left-clicking on a unit to select it.
Armed and ready.
Information about the selected unit is displayed at the bottom of the screen. Additionally, the commands for this unit are displayed in the bottom right. It is time to issue a command. Right-click the beacon to order the Marine to move to it.
Orders received.
Well done, recruit. Next, you will learn the attack move order. This is another way to instruct the Marine to move, but he will automatically attack any enemies along the way. Give the attack move order now. Press the attack key to enter the targeting mode, then left-click the ground to confirm your target location.
Outstanding.
That's it, Commander. I have noted your ability to follow basic instructions. The minimap will reveal an overview of the battlefield. It is located in the bottom left section of the screen. You may adjust your view of the battlefield anytime by moving your mouse to the edges of the screen. Try adjust. Hostile units detected. I will send you additional reinforcements. You can also left-click the minimap to change your view of the battlefield. Left-click the highlighted area on the map now to view your reinforcements. Very good, Commander. Your aptitude scores have exceeded the current average. You will need to select all of your Marines before engaging the hostile units. Left-click and hold to drag a box around your unit. The Dominion prizes cooperation. You may order a group of units in the same manner you would order an individual. Issue an attack move command to your Marines by pressing the attack key, then left-clicking the ground to confirm your target location. Your completion of this exercise has placed you in the 90th percentile of all Dominion recruits. Receiving transmission. Command simulation terminated.
Listen up. We've got a situation that needs a commander. And you're the best recruit we've seen for months. What do you say? Ready for some field experience?
You know, music volume. I have to set this to, look, you can play the music from StarCraft 1. Is it a windowed or a full screen? Take a cam station to record.
Welcome to Taurus 4. Not my favorite planet in the sector. Some of our science officers went out looking for Protoss artifacts last week, and those eggheads haven't returned yet. It can get ugly out there. I need you to establish a base and send out a search party. Your command center's landing now. You're gonna need some SCVs to handle your mining and construction. We're low on stored minerals, so let's get the SCVs gathering them.
Huh? Yeah, whatever.
Look at them go. They'll keep mining until you tell them to stop. Must think they're getting paid overtime. Check the top right corner of your screen to see how many minerals you've stockpiled. We're gonna need more SCVs to get all the minerals we need. You can train them up at the command center.
I notice it automatically sets a rally point for you and then automatically mines their minerals. That's something they didn't have in StarCraft 1.
Alright, now left-click the training. You're getting the hang of this. SCVs take time to get ready, but you can queue up some more while we wait. We'll need 12 SCVs to mine efficiently here. I'll even set up an objective for you at the top left of your screen so you can track your progress. Don't bother thanking me.
Using a shortcut key. There's a few other features that I've noticed that On top of my head, I don't remember because my movies got screwed up. Look, they got the message.
TV ready.
Can you play the message? Nope.
Nothing's free out here. Everyone on this base costs us a certain amount of supplies. Up in the top right corner of your screen, you'll see the current supply amount and its limits. Reach the limit, and we can't train anyone else. Good news is that SCVs can set up supply depots to increase our limit. Go on and order an SCV to build a supply depot.
What's going on?
All right. He'll be busy until the depot's finished. But after that, you can assign him a new task. Looks like that SCV's all done. But we don't have break times here. Let's get him back to mining.
So this is another feature. It shows you the workers that aren't being used.
You scared me! SCV ready!
That's right. Good. Those are all the SCVs we need. Next thing we're gonna need is a barracks to train our troops for combat. Select an SCV and order him to start building one.
The rear with the gear. SCV ready! SCV ready. Bad news.
The third thing is it shows you how many maximum.
That's a good-looking barracks, if I say so myself. Let's start training some Marines. We'll need 5 of them before we push out. Your objective has been updated so you can keep track.
Shows you how many maximum workers can be used on that building. That's another feature of those.
Big job, huh?
Build another barracks.
Armed and ready.
Well, double the army.
Go, go, go! Who wants some?
You can see through the barracks and see where the worker is. So you notice there's a worker there and it's not hidden.
Additional supply depots required.
You'll be promoted in no time if you keep this up. Let's get those Marines on the move. Time to find those missing scientists. Select your Marines and order them to head to the bridge. Hold on, Commander. I'm receiving some intel from our scanner suite. It's detecting Zerg biosignatures in this area. We're gonna have to be real careful with this one. Use your attack move command while exploring. Then your Marines will be on their guard if they come across enemies.
This better be good.
There's a move with the Protoss again. This ability from the air that I really like that I forgot to mention on my last 3 movies.
Orders received.
Well, there's our scientists. What's left of them. I'd better let HQ know about this. Hold here and wait for further orders.
Okay.
Your broodmother, and you will serve me to the death. First, you will make the Terrans suffer. suffer for their interference on this planet. I will join you soon with reinforcements. Prepare this hive cluster for my arrival. The hatchery is the heart of our hive cluster. It automatically spawns new lava over time. We can then morph these lava into more useful forms. You are low on supply, and your swarm cannot grow. Yes, as your swarm grows in number, you will need to continue to morph overlords to increase your supply.
Looks like I'm playing the Zerg now. Learn that.
Your hatchery has birthed more lava. Morph them into drones, and we shall grow your hive cluster. You now have two lava selected. Click them all. Good. Drones harvest resources and mutate into structures according to our needs.
Can't even play the game without hearing all the talking.
If you are to conquer this planet, you will require an army. But before you can create one, you will need a spawning pool. Order a drone to mutate into one now.
I'm missing some of the dialogue because I'm jumping ahead a little too fast.
Click them. Left click on the ground to be mutating a drone into a structure is permanent. Remember to morph more drones to account for this loss. That spawning pool looks noxious and fetid. Good. Now morph your lava into Zerglings. Each lava will become two Zerglings. Their strength comes from their numbers. Now I shall instruct you how to morph more advanced minions. But to do so, you will require Vespine gas. Ah, there is a Vespine geyser nearby. Excellent. First, you must order a drone to morph into an extractor above the geyser. Once that is finished, other drones will be able to harvest gas from it. You will require three drones to harvest Vespine gas from the extractor efficiently. Yes, the amount of gas you have gathered is shown in the top right corner. You are ready to strengthen your brood. A roach warren will allow you to morph stronger creatures. I see your mind is also evolving. Your roach warren is ready. You may begin morphing roaches. Roaches are bred to absorb damage. Their fortitude will help you conquer this world. You are ready to command my brood. Do not disappoint me. Let the Terrans tremble before us.
Surge! Unleash Hell Marines!
Phyton, bring their base to ruin.
This is the 21st Assault Division on Taurus 4. We are under attack by the Zerg. Do you read me? Immediate evac requested. We need...
The Zerg have claimed this world and all on it.
Graphics are smoother. You can, it's more like Warcraft 3. I wonder if you can tilt the screen forward like in Warcraft 3. But it's a lot smoother and a lot better than the original StarCraft.
Heed me, warriors. We have intercepted a Terran distress signal from Taurus 4. The Zerg have invaded the planet. We shall not let this stand. We must eradicate the enemy at once. The Terran transmission originated at these coordinates. It appears their warriors have already been infested by the Zerg. We must give them peace in death. I serve for now.
I like these lasers. Effects on the Protoss. Protoss, Protoss, tomato, tomato, potato, potato, whatever you want to call it. Smug jerk saying, oh, you're saying Proto's wrong.
Our forces are protected by their shields. They will regenerate quickly unless they take further damage. We have to go further. I must know how far the Zerg infestation has spread. As I feared, this world is consumed. I shall need the Golden Armada's aid to cleanse it. We will soon be outnumbered by the Zerg. We must fall back to safety. Our stalker should be able to cross the debris by using the Blink ability.
Very well.
These structures were abandoned long ago. But we can reactivate them, and hold here until the Armada arrives. Our gateways need a pylon to power them. Order a probe to warp in a pylon nearby. Pylons will power any nearby structures, and provide supply for our forces. Our probes are highly efficient. We can reassign them to other tasks after they have initiated the warp process.
Make two more pylons.
The gateways are now active. Let us use them to warp in zealots.
I like for
iron. You have Excellent. We now have enough zealots. But we cannot withstand the fight ahead without additional stalkers. We will require a cybernetics core in order to warp them in. Fine work. Stalkers will help us put an end to those Zerg. You have not enough minerals.
You require my skill.
Well done. Initiate warp sequences for the stalkers at our gateways. You have not enough minerals.
Shadows. I am the heart of darkness.
We have enough stalkers to proceed, but we must still be cautious, brothers. The Zerg approach our nexus point. Warriors, ready your blades!
The enemy is breaking through! We must hold!
Your bravery has brought us victory, my warriors. The Golden Armada has arrived.
We are the Swarm. Numberless. Merciless.
Initiating mass recall.
Weaklings, you retreat in the face of battle.
No, we strike as one.
You know, I like this part. This is the part I like. I'm wondering if this is a real building in a multiplayer game. Like a Billy from the air. I really like that. It's like that ghost and nuclear launch detected and all that. Coming up next is the stage 1 and stage 2 replays for these guys. Twenty-eight minutes, 40 seconds.